Welcome to the course on Test Your C Programming Skills, a guide to crack IT interview. We are discussing third topic of this course, that is arrays and pointers. In this session, we are going to discuss examples on pointer to arrays. In case of pointer to array, pointer is pointing to entire array. So it may point to a single or a multidimensional array. Syntax used to indicate pointer to an array is like this. Data type in the bracket star pointer name bracket complete and in the rectangular bracket size of the array. For example, int in the bracket star ptr and the size is 5. So here pointer ptr is pointing to an array of 5 integers. If pointer is pointing to one dimensional array, then to access ith element of that array, the syntax is used like this. In the bracket star pointer name bracket complete in the rectangular bracket I or star in the bracket one more bracket star pointer name bracket complete plus I. If pointer is pointing to two dimensional array, then to access element at position ij, syntax used is in the bracket star pointer name bracket complete and in the rectangular bracket I and j. Let's discuss first example of this session. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the code, on line number 5, there is a two-dimensional array A. On line number 6, there is a pointer to an array of integers, APTR. On line number 8, 10 and 12, it is displaying the value which is pointed by APTR. So what will be the output of this code? And the correct answer is, this code gives the output as a 3, 6 and garbage. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Please note that APTR is a pointer to array of 3 integers. Memory representation for the variables which are there in the program is shown in the figure. So there is an array which is having 4 rows and 2 columns. A00 is a 1. And last element is A31, which is 8. APTR is an array of pointers, which is pointing to address of A1. Here second dimension is missing and it is assumed to be as a 0. Line 7 makes APTR to point to address of A10. Here the missing dimension is assumed as a 0. And hence star APTR on line number 8 gives the 3 as an output. If we make APTR++, this causes pointer to move to 821. It has skipped 3 elements and now it is pointing to the element 6. This is because APTR is a pointer to array of 3 integers and that's why it skips 3 elements. So next time the output is 6. Another APTR++ causes pointer to point a new location which is out of the array and that's why this time it displays a garbage value. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. AI is an array of elements. PTR is a pointer to an array of size 2. PTR stores the address of AI. And then there are two printf statements on line number 8 and 9, which is displaying the value with the help of pointer PTR. And the correct answer of this program is, it will give the output as a 30 and 20. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Note that here PTR is a pointer to array of 2 integers. Here APTR is a pointer to array of 2 integers and it is pointing to A0. In the bracket star PTR, bracket complete, in the square bracket 2, this gives second element from the present position. And that's why 30 is displayed. Due to line number 9, that is star in the bracket star PTR plus 1 gives first element from the present position and that's why 20 is displayed. So this program gives the output as a 30 and 20. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. Again there is a two-dimensional array AI which is having 2 rows and 3 columns. And there is a PTR pointer, which is a pointer to an array of integers having size 1 row and 3 column. And then on line number 8, there is a printf statement which is printing the values pointed by PTR. So the correct answer of this program is, it will give the output as a 20 and 30. Let's understand why we are getting the output as a 20 and 30. Note that here PTR is a pointer to two-dimensional integer array. The two-dimensional integer array is having dimension 1 row and 3 column. So we can represent the given scenario in a figure like this. There is a two-dimensional array A, which is having 2 rows and 3 columns. PTR is pointing to address of AI 0. So here second dimension is missing, and that's why it is assumed as a 0. And PTR is pointer to an array of 1 row and 3 columns. So when we try to display the values, in the bracket star PTR, 0, 1 gives the element 20. And next, in the bracket star PTR, 0, 2 gives the element 30. So basically, it is displaying the values from the first row. And that's why the output is a 20 and 30. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully. Now this code is an extension of the previous example. So till line number 8, the code is exactly similar to the previous example. On line number 9, there is a PTR++, and on line number 10, it is again displaying the values of PTR. So the correct answer of this code is, the output is 20, 30, 40 and 50. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. So as explained in the previous figure, here PTR is pointer to an array of integers wherein the dimension of that array is 1 row and 3 columns. So after PTR++, PTR will now point to address of AI1, and that's why after making PTR++, when we are displaying the values, that is in the bracket star PTR00, it will give the value 40. And next value, that is in the bracket star PTR01, it will give the value 50. And that's why the program output is 20, 30, 40 and 50. So coming next is topic quiz on arrays and pointers. Till then, enjoy C programming.